Hey guys, welcome back to my channel and welcome to today's video in the Disney Walt Disney World vacation planning series. Today we are talking about dining. So first of all, the hair is up because it is hotter here right now than it is in Walt Disney World. So I would have very large hair if it was not tied back. Second of all, I'm trying a new light, so let me know if you notice a difference or anything like that. It is a ring light, so I might have a little bit of crazy eyes, but I don't think there's any glare behind me, and I'm kind of liking it. Plus, I'm getting used to putting more contacts in my eyes. So, but today I'm going to be talking about the Disney dining plan and just general information about it, and the different levels and everything, just kind of like if I think it's worth it, how to determine that and everything like that. So without further ado, let's get started. So the Disney dining plan is an option if you are staying at a Walt Disney World resort. So you have to be staying on site and it has to be booked like as a package. It has to be for your entire room. You cannot get it for only certain members of your party or not. If your child is 3 and under, they don't get a dining plan, like they can eat off your plate and that's fine. From age 3 to 9, they would be considered a child on the plan, and if they're 10 or older, they are considered an adult. The like biggest thing about the dining plan is it's all about convenience. So not necessarily the best value for your money, and it's more of like an all-inclusive feel. So you have the credits on your account and you can use them as you please, and you just don't have to worry about a lot, that it makes it really easy in that aspect. I will put a little picture of the symbol that means like dining plan. So if you are on the dining plan, you want to look out for this symbol, because that means that you are eligible to get that, whether it's on snacks, and sometimes on like quick service menus and stuff, but mostly a snack. Like if you're looking for a snack, you would want something with that symbol. The other thing to note is that during Flower and Garden Festival and Food and Wine Festival, I believe probably even during the Festival of the Arts, that symbol will be on the booths that you can get the like certain items as a snack credit. So I think that it can be worth it, but the biggest thing about it is that it's for convenience. So, and if I'm looking down, I'm looking at my notes. So for certain restaurants, it can definitely be worth it. If it's like a more expensive restaurant that like you're paying more for a meal there than you would be paying for like for your day of food, if that makes sense. And I will go down to like rough costs, but if you add up all the food that you're eating in a day versus what the cost is per day of the dining plan, like depending on the restaurant, there can be ones that are better value, or you're actually like making money, like you're saving money by doing it. For example, character meals can be a good value because they are a premium, like there is a premium price on that experience because you're getting the character interaction. That can be a good value, that can be a good use of a dining credit because it's expensive for what it is. So now I'm gonna go through the different levels of the dining plan. So there are 3 that are currently available. The first one is the quick service. So this is like the lowest level. So it includes 2 quick service meals. The meal would include 1 entree and 1 beverage. And it can be alcoholic if you're over 21. That's like the biggest thing that's changed in the last few years of the Disney dining plan, is alcohol is now included on the plan. It used to be just the highest level, but now it's included on all levels. And you get 2 snacks per day. This is per guest, and the dining plan works that it's per night of your stay. So if you're going for 7 nights, 8 days, you would get 7 days worth of credits. So it's, you get the set of credits for each night of your stay. So the price for that, and that's just going on the Walt Disney World website, pretending to like pick a room and then just adding the dining plan. Like, it breaks down the prices for you and it says this is what the package would be without it and this is what it is, and so just like subtracting it and then dividing it by two for two adults and everything like that. So for the quick service for an adult, it's approximately $52 per day. So if you think of, I have two quick service meals, those cost $20 each, that's $40. And then if I get two snacks per day, say those are each $5, so that's $50 of food, but it costs $52, then maybe that's not worth it. Kind of quick math. And then for a child ages 3 to 9, it would be approximately $25. So the next one is the standard. So that comes with one quick service menu. Just quickly, a quick service menu or quick service meal would be something like at McDonald's, where you go up to the counter and you order and then you take a tray of food to a table. And a table service meal is where you have a waiter that comes and brings your food to your table. So quick service is all quick service, no reservations, anything like that. So the standard is one quick service meal, which comes with one entree and a beverage, which can be alcoholic, and one table service meal, which is again a sit down, most likely need a reservation for it, one entree, a beverage, which could be alcoholic, and a dessert with lunch or dinner, or one buffet or family style meal. So for example, Crystal Palace at Magic Kingdom is a buffet, so that would be one credit. And like the Plaza restaurant in Magic Kingdom would be one table service because you're sitting down. And then you get two snacks per day. So the cost of that is approximately $75 for a day for an adult and $29 per day. But again, per night of your stay for a child. And you can't do it for like certain days and not. You can play around with credits, like you can kind of be like, okay, I have more reservations than credits, so I'm gonna pay cash for this one because it would be cheaper, then I'm gonna use my credits for here, kind of thing. I'll go a bit more into that after. And then the highest level is the deluxe, which covers all three meals. So you get one appetizer, one entree, one dessert, and one beverage, or a buffet, but you can use it for quick service or table service. Obviously the way to get more out of it would be to do all table service, but at the same time, that's a lot of sit down meals. That's a lot of time spent at sit down meals. Like if that's your thing, then do that. But I personally wouldn't want to eat a sit down restaurant every meal. And it includes two snacks. So that per day would be around $116 for an adult and $44 for a child. So the beverage is, so just in general for all three levels, the beverage is either alcohol or they have like signature ones down. So that would be like a milkshake, a smoothie, but then it would also be like soda, coffee, or tea. So they have kind of like upped the beverage game, and depending on the alcohol that you get, like that wouldn't include a bottle of wine, but I think it may include like a glass of wine or like a beer or cider or something like that. But the cost of that, like you'd be getting more for your money by having an alcohol beverage wherever you can. So again, the credit is per night of your stay. All credits are loaded when you check in. So you can use the credits how you want. You're kind of in charge of figuring that out. So you would want to make all of your reservations in advance and everything like that. Some restaurants cost two credits. So like Cinderella's Royal Table in the castle is two credits. California Grill at the Contemporary Resort is two credits. So again, you would want to take that into consideration. For all of the restaurants, it does say on the Walt Disney World website, like some dining plans accepted, like, and then it'll say like how many credits it is. So you can know that before you go, and you want to plan that for making reservations and everything like that. So you would want to take in consideration, okay, we're using two for this one, so if we want to do a sit-down meal per day, then okay, we'll have to pay for this one out of pocket. And like, we've done that before. We have done the dining plan a lot, and I've done it without it. Really, it's just convenience. I don't think you save any money. There are some instances where you can save money. Like, I think if you have young children and you're going to like the character meals, like I mentioned previously, like if you're doing things that are good value for, like good uses for the dining plan, you can definitely save money. There are Disney dining plan like calculators, I'll link one below, where you put in like either if you're just gonna go to like an average quick service or an average table service, or if you're thinking of certain restaurants, you can go and add all of those for like your certain days, and it'll tell you approximately how much it would cost if you were on the dining plan versus approximately how much it would cost if you were not. So also, like in my family, I have a very, very small appetite. Like many times when I go to restaurants, people think that there's something wrong with the food because I don't eat a lot of it, but also I just take it back and like take it and take it for lunch for the next day. But not in Disney, but I am like not the person that it's not that good of a value for me. And like at a buffet, you're paying a premium. I am not gonna come out ahead at a buffet, and like I don't really think anyone in my family would. My sister has an even smaller appetite than I do, so it really doesn't make sense for her to do that. And you can't be like, oh well, she doesn't need to be on the dining plan. Like it has to be all or nothing. On my last trip, we did do the dining plan, basically because you're prepaying for it, so it's one less thing to worry about. You just have to pay for tip. Tip is not included. It used to be, which used to be a really good deal. But again, like, so that wouldn't have been, doing the dining plan was not a great deal because we were on it. But for future, let me just make sure there's anything else. So you're prepaying it because you are adding it to your package, and your package has to be paid off before you start your trip. It can be somewhat restricting. Like when you sit down at a table service menu or at a table service restaurant, they will ask you if you're on the dining plan like first thing, and then they'll say, okay, you can order this, 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 or this. That you, the whole menu is not always an option, and they don't do substitutions. I remember one time, so I'm a pescatarian, so I eat fish but I don't eat meat, and I went to Tokyo Dining in the Japan Pavilion in Epcot and wanted a California roll bento box, but it had some sort of meat, and I was trying to say like, no, I don't want the meat, like I don't want to substitute it at all, like I just don't put that on my plate because I'm not gonna eat it. And they were like, no substitutions, like we can't even take that off. And so it was somewhat frustrating, and I haven't been back since, but my mom ended up taking it and it was fine. But it was frustrating because it's like very much like you can have this and that's it. So that's something to take into consideration. And yeah, like just the whole menu is not always an option because they are doing it to make money. So they're gonna pick, like, they've obviously thought about that. And so there are obviously gonna be things that you're only gonna have certain options. So tips aren't included, and then you can track your remaining credits in My Disney Experience. At the end of every meal, you'll get a receipt that will tell you how many meals you have, and like snacks and everything like that. Or you can also visit guest services at your resort and just ask for like an update, and they can tell you how many meals you have left. I feel like too, when you're on the Disney, like on the dining plan, you go and you're like, oh, like I want to reserve my credit, so I'll pay cash for this now, which like doesn't make any sense. And we totally had quick service meals left over at the end because Ethan and I can like split one, and that's fine for us. And so I remember staying at the Polynesian, being in the store, putting three snacks for every quick service meal. So I went home with all of this candy, because I had quick service remaining and like I didn't want to take a meal on the bus back to the airport. Like I just had, we had extra. So like even if you think that you're not gonna use all your credits, like don't pay cash for stuff. Like use your credits because you will probably be left with them. At the end, you can pay it forward and pay for someone's meal. We've done that before. But it is a lot of food and is not worth it for us. It's definitely just a convenience thing. And it just makes your trip like that much more relaxing. But I've also done it where I've tracked receipts and to see if it's worth it, and it's really not. So again, do the dining calculator, see if it's gonna be worth it for you. If you don't mind paying the extra just for the convenience, then go for it. Like I've done that too. Another option for Florida residents and DVC members is the Tables in Wonderland card. So what you do is you pay $150 to buy the card, and then you save 20% at most restaurants. It would be listed like on the website of what takes it and what doesn't, but it also includes alcohol. So potentially I am interested in trying it, so to be able to speak more of if it's a value or not, but in theory you would be saving 20% on every meal including alcohol, which can definitely add up, and depending on the restaurants that you're going to, you could make back that $150 in savings plus even more. You can use it for up to 10 people for one card, and then your spouse could also buy a supplementary card for $50, and then you can use it for up to 20 people. The person who has the card, the payment has to go on like a credit card matching that name, but sounds like a pretty good deal, so hopefully I will have a chance to try that at some point. I think that is it. Like I said, I've done the dining plan, I haven't done it. I don't think that it's worth it, but if convenience is worth it to you, then I think that it makes sense. If that makes sense. So I think that's it for the dining. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you are a dining plan person or if not. And I will be back in a few weeks with another Disney planning video. If you liked this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. And if you've missed any of the other videos in this series, I will have that playlist linked down below. I'll put it up there and it'll also be at the very end of the video. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great rest of your day and I'll see you next time. Thanks again for watching. Bye.